It's a very innovative study, and it's quite unique to the Great Lakes. We're actually able to track the fish 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. So we can actually track the movements of fish during times of the winter season. So we're actually seeing patterns and behavior that we normally wouldn't be able to see any other time. This information informs the practitioners on where to put the habitat and how to build the habitat, and actually can drive the designs and definitely improve the different types of fisheries habitat that is put into the waterfront.
In order to track these fish in the harbor, we first have to deploy our acoustic receivers. We have about 70 receivers scattered in areas throughout the entire Toronto Harbor. They're essentially listening stations. We capture the fish, we do a quick surgery to implant the acoustic transmitter inside the stomach cavity of the fish, and then once that fish is put back in the water, it'll periodically emit a sound signal from the tag inside of it that, when close enough to these listening stations, will be picked up, and that data will be decoded and stored on the receiver station. Not only will it tell us the location of the fish, but it can also give us information on the water temperature that the fish was in, the depth at which the fish was swimming, and even the activity level of the fish. It can tell us where fishes are aggregating, whether that be over winter under the ice, or where the habitats they're using during their spawning period, the movement rates, and better still, because we're part of a collaborative research network in the Great Lakes, if any of the fish that we tag here in the Toronto Harbour move west towards either the Hamilton Harbour or Welland Canal, or even further into the other Great Lakes, we have a network of research colleagues with receivers scattered all throughout the Great Lakes, and when one of those fish is picked up on their receiver, they're able to identify that that fish originated in the Toronto Harbour. We do this by tracking over 300 individual fish from 8 different species. Collaborating with the Department of Fisheries and Oceans and Toronto Conservation Authority on this project has been invaluable. And also the local expertise and knowledge in terms of the fish community and the habitats in the Toronto Harbour. Without the collaborative nature, a project this large would be nearly impossible.